Let's talk about variability. To measure the variability of each neuron individually, we can use the variance, which describes the spread of the distribution of firing rates around its average value. The covariance, in contrast, measures the tendency of two neurons to increase or decrease their firing rates together compared to their average values. Mathematically, these are defined by the following equations. The covariance of x1 and x2 is the expectation of the product of x1 and x2 minus the product of the expectations. And notice that if you plug in the covariance of x1 and x1, then you recover the usual equation for variance that we know and love. The covariance is in slightly weird units because if you measure the firing rates in hertz, then the covariance would be in hertz squared. So you can get rid of this weird units by dividing by the product of the standard deviations. And this also normalizes this quantity to be within -1 and +1. We call this the correlation coefficient. All of this information can be summarized in the covariance matrix, which is usually called capital sigma. This is an n by n matrix whose ijth element is the covariance of xi and xj. That means that the jith element is also the covariance of xi and xj. So the covariance matrix is symmetric across its diagonal. And if you look along the diagonal, then the ith element is given by the variance. So the important things to remember about this matrix are that the variances are on the diagonal, the covariances are on the off-diagonal, and it's a symmetric matrix. And another way to write this is that sigma is equal to its own transpose. This affords the covariance matrix with some important quantities that will be used in PCA, but we'll get to that in a later lecture. In the first exercise, you'll model neural data as coming from a multivariate normal distribution. This is a generalization of a one-dimensional normal distribution to n dimensions with a given covariance structure. So the joint distribution is given by this exponential form that's written here. Mu is the mean of each variable, or each neuron's firing rate, and sigma is the covariance matrix. And if you look at the marginal distribution of each neuron separately, then you recover the original one-dimensional Gaussian. So now it's your turn to play around with the covariance matrix and see how this affects the geometry of your data.